Good morning, children. In the last class in the previous week, we have started about subjects and predicates. Today, we will read about nouns. Okay? You all know, in English, there are 8 parts of speech. What are they? Noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, preposition, and conjunction. And interjection. Now, today we will read nouns. There are different kinds of nouns. Okay? And today we will read about 6 kinds of nouns. Number 1, common nouns. Number 2, proper nouns. Number 3, abstract nouns. And number 4, collective nouns. The other two are countable nouns and uncountable nouns. First of all, you have to know what are nouns. Naming words are called nouns. Okay? Names of persons, places, animals, things, or even ideas. Naming words are called nouns. For example, Ram, Kolkata, boy, girl, etc. Okay? Common nouns. What are common nouns? Common nouns are the names of persons, places, animals, or things. Okay? Which are of the same kind. Common nouns are the common names of persons, places, animals, or things which are of the same kind. For example, boy, girl, city, country, etc. Is it clear, children? Now come to proper nouns. What are proper nouns? Proper nouns are the special names of a particular person, place, animal, or thing, and they begin with the capital letter. For example, Kolkata, Ram, Delhi, Ganges, etc. So proper nouns are the special names of a particular person, place, animal, or thing, and they begin with the capital letter. Is it clear? Now come to abstract nouns. What are abstract nouns? An abstract noun is the name of some feeling, idea, or quality which we cannot touch, which we cannot see, but we can feel it or we can think of it. For example, honesty, honesty, pain, truth, cruelty, etc. So, what is an abstract noun? An abstract noun is the name of some quality, idea, or feeling which we cannot touch, which we cannot see, but we can feel it or we can think of it. Suppose the baby is in pain. The baby cried in pain. In this sentence, pain is the abstract noun. We can see pain? No. We can touch pain? No. But we can feel pain. We can think of pain. But we cannot see or we cannot touch. Similarly, tell me the truth. In this sentence, truth is the abstract noun. Okay? Can we touch truth? No. Can we see truth? No. But we can feel truth. But we can, or we can think of truth. Okay? Is it clear? An abstract noun usually used in the form of singular form. It is used in the singular form. Okay? Afterwards, I will discuss about singular and plural. Now, collective nouns. What are collective nouns? Collective nouns are the names of collections of persons, places, persons, animals, or things. Collective nouns are the collections of persons, animals, or things considered as one whole. Okay? Considered as one whole. For example, punch, feet, bundle, army. So, in what way we will say? Suppose bunch of keys, fleet of ships, bundle of sticks, army of soldiers. So, this bunch, fleet, bundle, army, all these are collective nouns. Is it clear, children? Collective nouns are the names of collections of persons, animals, or things. Okay? Now, countable nouns. What are countable nouns? Nouns which can be counted are called countable nouns. For example, eggs, eggs, cups, tables, chairs, etc. Okay, children, so all these are countable nouns which we can count. Uncountable nouns. What are uncountable nouns? Nouns which cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. For example, water. Can we count water? No. So, water, milk. Can we count milk? No. Tea. Can we count tea? No. Soap. Can we count soap? No. So, all these are uncountable nouns. Nouns which cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. One thing you should remember, countable nouns asks how many eggs are there, how many cups are there, how many tables are there, you can count it, which you can count. It asks how many, and uncountable nouns, it asks how much water, how much milk, how much tea, like this, okay? Though we cannot count uncountable nouns, but we can count it in some other manner. For example, bucket of water. Bucket of water. You can say like this, okay? Milk. A bucket of water. 2 cups. Of tea, 3 glasses of water or 4 cakes of soap. Okay, children, so these are all uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns are those which we cannot count. Okay, now let's come to the exercises. Open page class 5 students, just open your language book page 19. A. Exercise A. Circle the common nouns and underline the proper nouns. Number 1. Mr. Verma is a doctor in this hospital. So, Mr. Verma, it is proper noun. It is a name, it's a special name of a particular person. So, Mr. Verma is the proper noun. Doctor is the common noun. So circle doctor and hospital, one more common noun. So circle hospital. Okay. Number 2. We always travel by the Air India. Which one is the proper noun over here? Air India. It is written in capital letter and it is a special name. So, Air India is the proper noun. In this sentence, there is no common noun. Now, number 3. Vidhi wants to be an actress when she grows up. Vidhi is the proper noun. So, underline Vidhi. Actress is the common noun. So, circle actress. Number 5, the Red Fort is a monument. Red Fort, this is a special name and it is written in capital letter. So, it is the proper noun. So, underline Red Fort. Monument is a common noun. It is a common name. So, make circle over monument. Number 6. We will go to Delhi by the Rajdhani Express. Delhi is the proper noun. It is a special name. And Rajdhani Express is another proper noun. It is also a special noun, a special name. Number 7. Sachin Tendulkar is a cricketer. Underline Sachin Tendulkar. It is a special name of a particular person. So, it is a proper noun. And cricketer is the common noun. It is the common name. Number 8. Jyoti gave the book Oliver Twist to her classmate. So book is the common noun, is a common name. Oliver Twist, it is written in capital letter and it is a special name of a particular book. So Oliver Twist, underline Oliver Twist, it is a proper noun. In classmate, another one, common noun, it is a common name. Now number 9, Rajiv and Somnath are friends. Rajiv, it's a special name of a particular person. So Rajiv, proper noun. Somnath, another one, proper noun. It is also a special name of a particular person. Friends. Friends is a common noun. It is a common name. Now, number 10. Arun will visit Kolkata in October. Arun is the proper noun. Kolkata is another proper noun. October is also a proper noun. All these are in capital letter and all these are special names. Now, exercise B. Match the common nouns with groups of proper nouns. Rivers. You have to find out the names of the rivers first. What are the names of the rivers? Ganges, Yamuna, Godavari. So, number A, river is number 6. So, like this, you have to do the matching. You know in what way you have to do the matching. So, just do it at home. It is your homework. Page 19, exercise B is your homework. Page 19, exercise B, homework. Okay, practice it at home. Now, open page 20. Honesty is a great quality. Exercise C. Which one is the abstract noun? Honesty. Number 2, my mother gave me some necessary advice. Which one is the abstract noun? Advice. Number 3, my grandfather always believed in truth. Which one is the abstract noun? Truth. Number 4, his bravery won him many awards. Which one is the abstract noun? Bravery. Number 5, I have experience of traveling to distant places. Which one is the abstract noun? Experience. Number 6, you should read books to gain knowledge. Which one is the abstract noun? Knowledge. Number 7, it was a pleasure meeting you. Which one is the abstract noun? Pleasure. Number 8, she could hardly speak because of fear. Fear is the abstract noun. Number 9, Rajiv shared some sweet memories of his childhood with me. Which one is the abstract noun? Memories. So, underline memories. Number 10, everyone knows about her kindness towards dogs. Abstract noun, kindness. So you have to underline kindness. In this way, you have to do. Now, number D, exercise number D. Write the quality that these people have. So, a sincere person, what type of quality a sincere person should have? Sincerity. It has been given in your book. One example has been given in your book. So, like this, you have to do the rest. Number 2, an honest man. So, honesty will be the quality of an honest man. So, honesty will be the answer. Number 3, a happy child. Happiness will be the quality of a happy child. So, happiness is the answer. Number 4, an angry boss. Anger is the quality of an angry person. So, anger is the answer. Number 5, a brave soldier. Bravery is the quality of a brave soldier. So, bravery will be the answer. Number 6, a proud lady, pride. Pride will be the answer. Number 7, a kind man, kindness will be the answer. Number 8, a beautiful princess, beauty will be the answer. Now, page 21, find the opposites of these abstract nouns in the word great. You have to find out the opposites. Okay? From this word great. So, number 1, sorrow. What will be the opposite of sorrow? Happiness. Number 2, cowardice. What will be the opposite of cowardice? Courage. Number 3, ugliness. What will be the opposite of ugliness? Beauty. Truth, lie. Hatred, love. Foolishness, wisdom. Pleasure, pain. Dishonesty, honesty. Now for F. Number F exercise. Form nouns by adding dumb, itty, men, th, y, ness, or ty to the words given below. This will be your homework. Understand? So page 21, just try it at home. Okay children, I think you will get impressed when you will do this. Page 21, exercise F. Exercise F will be your homework. Okay, now number G. Under Dr. Sharma's dash, my mother is now recovering from her illness. So what will be the answer? Treatment. When you will construct this number 4, 5, number F, you will get some sorts of words like sweetness, reality, equality, treatment, honesty, freedom, formality, foolishness, growth, cruelty. With these words, you have to fill in the blanks. Okay? So number 1, under doctors, treatment, my mother is now recovering from her illness. Number 2, I can comment on the sweetness of the juice after I test it. Number 3, in our country, there is equality between the rich and the poor. Number 4, the king showed his foolishness by allowing the thief to escape. Number 5, the cutter's honesty impressed the fairy. Number 6, he fought against cruelty towards animals. Number 7, we fought for our freedom. Number 8, the plants show slow growth in winter. In this way, you have to do. Now turn your page 22, collective nouns. So you have to learn all this. A fleet of sheep, a string of pearls, a brood of chicks, a tuft of grass, a swarm of bees, a constellation of stars, a bunch of keys, a crew of sailors, a bundle of sticks, a team of players. So all this you have to learn by heart. And page 22, I'm giving you some homework. Page 22. Exercise H. Exercise H. I. J. K. J. K. Okay. All these are your homework. Just try it at home. Okay, children. I think you will get interest when you will do this. Okay. Okay. Then next day we will do noun numbers. Okay. So that's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day. Okay.